Alright everybody, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Lamax Caged Monster. Let's get into it. Okay, so the Caged Monster. This one is super cool, but I think a little underrated. I never see too many people talking about it or say that they're looking for it or even pictures that show that they have it in their village somewhere. I'm sure people do, but it's definitely not one that you consistently hear about. And I'm guilty of this too. I didn't even know it exists, to be honest with you. I happened to be searching on a website one time and saw someone selling it. And I as soon as I saw it, I was like, whoa, what is this? You know? Super cool, very lightweight, but it's a good thing. The build quality is great. This has nothing to do with build quality, but the weight of it feels like the box is empty. Super cool for moving it around. You know, some houses are really heavy and, you know, they all add up, right? And this one though, super light, easy to move around. So let's get into some of the details. It was released in 2004, and there was not a retirement date listed, but it is believed to be retired. I mean, it's from 2004, but again, it just didn't happen to have the date for that. As for some dimensions here, we got 8.27 inches high, 7.87 inches wide, and 5.20 inches deep. So it is good size for an accessory. It's tall, to be honest. The tree is quite tall. And as far as scale, I think that the monster is a little larger than maybe some of the other pieces. Now, he is a monster, so maybe that justifies it right there. But nothing to the point where it would look odd or wouldn't fit in or anything like that. So let's move on to the power. This thing offers something really cool. It's a dual power, and that's how it was listed on the box as well. And what that means is it's both battery operated or your standard 4.5 volt DC adapter. So you could put three AA's in the back, and there is a switch that I'll show you later on the back of the unit. There's no like wire switch that you would see in like a house or newer accessories, things like that. So three AA's or, you know, your standard 4.5 volts DC adapter. Also a great time to use one of those like multi adapters, because it's not something that pulls a lot of power. I've said in past videos never to use them on your houses, but for accessories sometimes they can be cool. So moving on, the product type is of course accessory, and it's made of a poly resin. And the description that Lamax had listed is, the angry fellow rattles his cage back and forth. Pretty accurate description, except for I think he's a monster more than he is a fellow. When they came out, they were $19.99. Now this was of course 2004, but now they seem to be going for about $40 on the low side for a good working one, of course used, all the way up to $90. So be cautious, you know, some of those websites can get pretty out of the realistic world. So if you can pick one up for, you know, $40, $50, something like that, that's something you can feel good about. And as you're about to see in all the detail we're gonna go through, it's more than worth it. So we've already covered the fact that it is weight-wise really light, but what else does this thing have to offer? There's quite a bit. So starting with the overall lighting, this thing captures the eye, and a lot to do with the pumpkins. As you can see, I'll kind of come in here for you. They're kind of flashing back and forth there, and they're really bright. They're not dim like a lot of, you know, sometimes you buy like accessories that are just pumpkins and they kind of get dim and stuff, and or maybe not as bright as you wanted them to be. Happens, no big deal. But these, no, these are shining bright, really bright. As far as the rest of the lighting, you have what appears to be blue on camera, but it's really UV, and it reflects so cool on the gravestones. And it's also reflecting a little bit up onto the monster, and you can kind of see that it creates like that really neat shadow behind it as well. When we dim the lights though, you're really gonna see how it brings everything to life. And like even like the letters here and the little skull and stuff on the little gravestones, they kind of interact with that UV, and just it brings it to a whole nether level. So the next thing I want to talk about is the cage monster himself. Kind of resembles more like a Frankenstein kind of feel, but definitely cool. And the cage and the contrast of his colors are really nice together. There's a little metal chain, of course, hanging from the tree. It does appear and feel to be like a thin metal to me, thick enough to take the abuse though. Next thing is going to be the tombstones. We spoke a little bit about them earlier. They are just spooky. And again, you're in the heart of those 2004 years, you know, the classic Spooky Town years. This is the kind of stuff they were producing. Really spooky stuff. This thing has that feel like, you know, there might be something weird going on here, right? There's some small details as well, though, like some little skeleton heads in the trees and, of course, a big guy sitting right there. Probably would have been cool to see, like, maybe some green on him somewhere to kind of go with the UV light since it was shining that direction anyway. There's also a pile of skulls here, which is cool. And for those of you who like to, like, model the houses, you know, and, like, refurbish them, things like that, there's space on here for stuff like that. You could easily glue on more tombstones or more rocks or even more trees, you know, whatever you see fit. There's a room for that on this one. That's something that I kind of like about it. Moving on from that is the ground itself. This is going to be a little odd here, but the ground looks pretty realistic. I don't know why it stuck out to me. I think there was one other piece that we did somewhere in the channel, and it was kind of like a similar thing, but it looked really fitting on this one. I don't know. It tied in perfectly. And last but not least, there is this cool little boulder that's under the monster as well. I assume there's some magnet or something in there helping him do his thing. That would be my guess probably why it's there. But it doesn't look out of place. It's really, everything kind of just fit really well together on this piece. I think that if you're looking for, you know, another focal point in the village or something to kind of fill things up, but, you know, look the part and really give that spooky feel, this is it right here. You're looking at it. It offers everything from height to detail to overall feel, and of course the light up pumpkins just drive it home. Overall, I absolutely love this piece. I'm looking forward to putting it in our village this year. You know, am I wrong about it being underrated? Let me know in the comments below. You know, do you have one? Let us know in the comments below. I think it's a must have. I can't help but love it. And I think that anyone who else would pick one up would love it too. But again, maybe I'm wrong. If you don't like it, let me know why too. You know, I want to learn just like everybody else. It's a really fun piece. Thank you so much for checking out my channel. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you on the next one.